nation, not the Kisi nation, the Crown nation, the Pella nation, the Konga nation, the Mandingo nation, or the Ba nation. One nation, and that's the Abiri nation. Let me share with you a very small story. It's an old story about an elephant hunter. And the story goes that this hunter had been going for many, many months without winning anything, without being able to have a catch. So on this day, he went to hunt. He was fortunate to have gathered a very, very big elephant. But he had one problem. How could this hunter bring this elephant to town? So he was struggling with his elephant. My elephant, my elephant. And he kept dragging, and he was unsuccessful. So he left from the bush, he came to the town people, and he said, please come and help me. All of you come and help me so that I can bring this elephant to town. Now mind you, the townspeople, some of them have been winning deer, some squirrels, some have been catching rabbits. They had something during the year. But this hunter, this elephant hunter, had nothing. So they followed him and they went in the bush. So the town people and the hunter, they were all coming back now. Our elephant, our elephant, our elephant. So he said, no, 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 wait a minute. This is my elephant. It's not our elephant. During the time of the year, some of you caught red deer, some of you caught rabbit, some of you caught something, but I caught nothing. So this is my elephant. So the people say, okay, that's fine. We'll leave you with the elephant and we'll go back to town. So they left him with his elephant and they all went back to town. And then he was struggling. My elephant, my elephant. And the elephant would not move. So he ran back to the town. He said, okay, I beg all of you, please follow me. Let's go back in the bush and bring to town our elephant. And then together, the whole group are going, our elephant, our elephant, our elephant. And they brought this elephant to town. I was so overwhelmed thinking of who is going to be credited for this thing. And in the midst of that struggle, we miss out on the big, big picture. There are two things that unite people everywhere in the world. The first one is love. When people love or have the same passion for something, they can all easily come together and support that thing. We saw it during a recent county meeting. Who's here from Bond County? Or Grand Cru? Or Sano? Or Nima? Everyone was supporting his team somehow. There was this source of unity at a very smaller level. And when Lone Star is playing, we all go and we support the Lone Star. It's because of love. The second thing that saves the soul is hate. When people hate the same thing, they can become strange bedfellows. And together, they form a critical mass and even go and recruit other people to join them in their pursuit of hate. Where do you stand? To love, unity in love, or to hate, unity in hate. The Liberian experience in reality. The Liberia we want. Everyone has influence. Everyone. A small story. This town was a deer hunter. The story goes that this deer hunter went in the bush and he caught a very big deer. But you know, there's this law that when you catch an animal, you cut off the tail, right? So like, it doesn't change to a human being. In the traditional sense, there was a law passed that when you catch an animal, you cut the tail. So this hunter cut off the tail of his deer, and then he cut off a very small piece from around the shoulder, and then he cut off the ears. He sat in the bush and he roasted a little bit of meat. And then he put his flesh on his shoulder along with the roasted meat and he brought it to town. He met his children at home. And when he dropped the meat in the kitchen, and then he came in with the roasted meat, and he shared with them. But the meat was not enough. So there was a struggle. His children started to fight amongst themselves. They fought so much that they wasted it with a barbecue. They fought for so many days over just the roasted meat the hunter had brought home. So their neighbors went in the kitchen and saw this abandoned red deer. And so they decided to cut it off and to roast it. And somebody cooked pepper soup. There was a whole barbecue chain. They decided to make a lot of money out of their father's sweat. While they were busy fighting over small barbecue that their father, the hunter, had brought for them. That's our Liberian reality. We are sitting in town fighting and killing each other. And foreigners are in our bushes, mining our gold and diamond in Sando, in Bourbon-Gile, in Bong County, in Nimba, fishing in our waters, becoming millionaires and billionaires, and we are fighting over a small spoon of barbecue when the deer sits in the kitchen and is getting spoiled and everything is turning to rot when we are sitting fighting over barbecue. Enemies are not those from the heights of Duco, but it's those from the depths of West Point. Or those from the neglected beaches in Southtown, but it's those from the smoke-filled air of Bay Ashland. Not those from the banks of the St. John River, or those from the womb of the Bellingham Forest. They are ignorance, disease, and poverty. A few things to look at from the Liberian reality. Just look at it. Two things. How we behave in traffic, how we drive, and how we build our roads. In traffic, there's so much disrespect. Disrespect for the rule of law, for police officers, for other drivers, for pedestrians, for ourselves. We are sitting in the middle of the traffic to national development. We are blocking our own assets to development. And how we build our roads? Like this. If I have my house in an alley, the bend it around my house. And then there's a kitchen on the main road, so the bend it the other side. So when the laws are confronting us, we find a way to remove ourselves from the face of the law to suit ourselves. How we drive and how we behave in traffic. False sense of entitlement. Because my father was a paramount chief, so I see as my birthright to be in government. Or my grandfather was postmaster general, so I have automatic access to public resources. How do we behave in traffic? How do we respect each other, even in this agreement? I want you to please note this. The first step in respecting a friendship is to acknowledge that you both will not always be on the same side. Someone posted on social media that Liberia does not need elections, but Liberia needs the revolution of the mindset of the people. And I believe that revolution is taking place right now, February 7th, 2020, in the Empowerment Temple, AME Church. Please give a hand to the Global Leadership Summit. To the people on the board of the GLS, thank you so much. I will tell you a very short story of an experience I had during the Civil War. In 1994, we were in PB, at the PB Hospital and School of Nursing. And this day, there was a massacre. It is documented. It's a massacre that occurred there in 1994. My family, my sister is here, and my mom were in this hospital, were trying to flee, to leave through the front door. But the killing was going on right at the front door, so our only option was to go in the back and just hide somewhere. So we went in the back, and when we did, there was no door, there was no window, nothing. So we just, the morning, it was a record room in fact. So why in the record room, somebody almost miraculously saw a small light. And that person went to the light. When they opened it, it was the door. And they took the box from the end to the front of it and pushed it. And we saw the light. And that was how we escaped to that back door. The person who saw that light was not a formal leader in that group. They had no formal form of leadership. It was just an ordinary woman. So that door that we fled through in Phoebe in 1994 is the door to the new Liberia. It's that door that will take us to the future. If you find that door as a Liberian, don't sneak through it and close it behind you. Lead others along. Find someone and take them along as you go through that door. And don't shut it behind you, because there are others coming after. Leave traces so that they can see the light and know how to get out. Avoid negative competition. It takes us nowhere. I want to talk to the young people especially. I want to charge you, members of the Joshua generation, who will take Liberia towards the promised land. The time to leave will come. Take more time to prepare and learn and unlearn and ask and seek wisdom, understanding, so that when the time comes, you'll be charged the gospel words and understand and define the purpose of this generation, the Joshua generation. As we find that door that will take us towards the promised land, I want us to remember, as President William R. Tubman said, that the enemies of Liberia remain ignorance, disease, and poverty. And the crown that of this unity. May God bless the sons of King Sao Bosu. May God bless the sons and daughters of Matilda Leopold and those of the Mayflower. May God bless the sons and daughters of King Long Peter and King Jimmy, ancestors and forefathers. May God bless all of the market women, the nectar roamers, the grain goose hustlers, who funded this nation. And may God continue to bless the people in this glorious land of liberty, so long remain ours. Believe it. God bless you.